This is Infinite Health Clips, and I hope you enjoy this segment with Dr. Ishad Agarwal. My next question after acne would be loose skin, because that's something I personally dealt with also, and I've come to you several times. I mean, not just the stretch marks, but I mean, can skin elasticity come back to its original form?
That's a very complex question, and I'll tell you why I say that is because A, you have to see how fast has a person's collagen. Now, skin essentially becomes loose, to speak of, is when the skin loses its collagen and elastin content, right? Now, it's happening to each one of us at different rates. So our genetics are differently wired. Some people will have loose skin faster and some people will have it slower. We can definitely not bring the skin back to its complete original strength. But if you are conscious enough to start early, there are certain treatments called as collagen induction treatments. So the idea is to bring back collagen as fast as it's deteriorating. So you start your collagen induction programs pretty early on in life and you maintain a decent elasticity and firmness to your skin. But if you've completely, for example, somebody who's lost like weight rapidly and they have a lot of excess skin afterwards, there are two options. Either they can go in for a surgery, get the abdominoplasty done for the body or wherever the loose skin is, and then tighten the remaining skin with non-invasive treatments. But if you do not want to go to a surgeon and get a surgery done, then you need to have a more realistic idea about how much elasticity can come back and get into treatments like Hyfu, Morpheus.
So this is what I wanted to get into deeper. Like, what does Hyfu or Morpheus entail? I mean, if I get a Hyfu done or if I get a Morpheus done, what exactly happens and how long does it take for the treatment to be effective?
So, see, you have to understand that most of the non-invasive devices, and I'm talking about invasive, like semi-invasive also, like Morpheus, the depth that the treatment is going to go to is about 13 mm for Hyfu and maybe 4 to 5 mm for Morpheus, right? So you're looking at superficial skin tightening. So it would take, since we are generating new collagen, it does take a couple of months before you see any major outcomes. And also you have to be sure that you're supplementing your diet with enough proteins for that protein synthesis and collagen induction to happen. Thirdly, you cannot have intervals of maybe while you're on the treatment, you again suddenly gained weight. And then again, you've suddenly lost. So you are, that battle between constant collagen degradation, then the collagen degradation is going to win again.
So good lifestyle has to accompany the treatment.
It is part of everything that we are doing. Because what happens, most people, they're coming for shortcuts. They're coming for quick fixes. And the quick fixes will only last as much. The quick fix is only going to last for a certain time period. If you want it to be a more permanent change, you need to have a better lifestyle to coordinate with the ongoing treatment.
I just wanted to ask, skin tightening is one thing, but, we all have subcutaneous fat. Right? Mm-hmm. And they say that subcutaneous fat is a fat within the skin.
Yeah.
So is there a treatment that can be used for subcutaneous fat also? Because they say it's harmless. They say that subcutaneous fat is harmless, but it really looks bad on someone.
There are certain treatments as well. You could go for, again, there's something called school sculpting that helps you really good for the pinchable fat. The Hyfu, to some extent, it works, but it's predominantly for the skin tightening itself. The cryolipolysis, machines that have this ability to freeze the fat, and then the fat is then taken care, excreted from the body. Those are the kind of machines you need to go for, the subcutaneous fat. But again, the issue that I have with these treatments is they've been marketed in such a wrong manner. They've been, in India specifically, they've been marketed as weight loss programs, which I feel is sad because they are not intending to make you lose weight. They're intending to reduce the subcutaneous fat. So, for example, somebody who's been going to the gym regularly has lost a lot of weight and there is this resistant belly fat which is not going. Like, this person is a lean person otherwise. Yes, go ahead and do the cool sculpting. But somebody who weighs 120 kgs is a lot of fat per se, and you do cool sculpting, it's not going to work for you.
Right.
These are meant for for, you know, those resistant fat pockets and not as a weight loss program.
If you had to summarize, if you had to give like an absolute summary of how one should take care of his skin, I mean, what would you say to that?
Okay, so what I would tell people is keep it simple. If you keep it simple, you'll be able to do it consistently for a long period of time. If you're going to complicate yourself with 20 products, you'll definitely not be able to follow through. Second would be, please go to a dermat in your city. Find a proper skincare routine and stick to that. Do not do your own research. Do not follow the influencers. Because every day the market is being flooded with 10 different products and you'll be totally confused. If you really want to start out with just 3 to 4 products, a good cleanser, a good moisturizer, a good sunscreen, and a good active product at night, depending upon your concern. Start with just 4 products and then build on top of that.
This is something that you told me also.
Just like 4 products. After a month, maybe add a 5th product. Or maybe after 2 months, after 3 months. And the funny thing is, people have been using these products. They're doing fine. Their skin is absolutely at its best. And then one fine day, they come and tell me, I ordered this and this product. And now my skin is not doing so well. And the reason is they got bored. And I'm like, wow. If you're getting bored of your skincare routine, what else do you do? Because, and that's a myth that I want to break. You do not have to keep on changing your skincare routine. If your skincare routine is absolutely doing fine for you, why do you want to change it?
Right.
Change it when you feel the need for bringing something new. And then like you have a new concern. Or when you feel that the skincare routine is not working anymore for you.